the BEO, whereby he has authorized collection of illegal fees of 15,000 from candidate classes for e-registration. This should have been free.
Those arrested include Acting District Education Officer Richard Eliebu and the District Senior Commercial Officer David Eyamo. Eliebu is accused of charging an illegal fee of 15,000 shillings for each of the primary seven candidates in the previous year. Akello also said the officer in charge of Emioga failed to account for three Emioga circles in Kabaremaido district.
When we tried to give him information that there are some other ghost circles within Kabaremaido, Emioga circles, he was even saying that there are others who received money and disappeared and he didn't bother to look for them. And he's just not interested in any work. So we are investigating him, whether he's the one behind those ghost circles. So the State House Anti-Corruption Unit, they're investigating him.
Eliebu initially said he did not know about the money, but later said it was the head teachers that knew about the money for photos and photo albums of the candidates. Eyamo also said it was the microfinance center responsible for financing the Emioga circles.
We have those youth that we can give them a success story. It is not there. We have web. We don't have success story. We have even our recent one, Emioga. We don't have a success story. We have now the last bullet called PDM, not forgetting that the other one called Misaku was giving a lot of money.
Beatrice Akello Akori, the minister in charge of economic monitoring at State House, later visited Kabaremaido Technical Institute, where a multi-billion project remains idle.
It was a cold one. It was only known to the contractor. The contractor did not tell us that there was a faulty cable. So when we switched on, there was short circuit. That short circuit thing disabled all the machines. We could not now use the machines. And it took us a very long time to find out the fault until we contacted the Luero Industries. But now we could not continue using the machines because of that problem.
Another project that Akello visited was the construction of Pereira Seed Secondary School worth 2.5 billion shillings. Akello urged technical officers and district leaders to get serious about service delivery.
So many projects and programs the government are running in this district, including in roadworks, like UGIFT project going on very well, roadworks going on well, though with some gaps where we find the contractors not completing work, or the district using the fossil account. They have not completed what they have begun to do. So those gaps we have detected here.
Sectors that were of concern included works, health, and shortlisting process in the district.
Report by Michael Onyinye for the news.